أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله فاتر السماوات والأرض جاهل الملائكة رسلا أولي أجنحة مثنى وثلاث ورباع وصلى الله وسلم على سيدنا محمد القائل لا يزال أهل المغرب ظاهرين على الحق حتى تقوم الساعة صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين أما بعد رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي. We had started the past time to talk about the biography of the chuyukh of the silsilah of the tariqah Karkariya. So inshallah we'll continue in that way, and today we'll talk to you about the biography of Sheikh Ahmed al Alawi. Sheikh Ahmed al Alawi is someone very known in the world as a great saint and a great wali of Allah, and we know that he's of the shuyukh of our silsilah because he was a sheikh of Mawlai Tahir al Karkari, from whom we met a biography in the past time. So today we'll talk to you about the biography of Sheikh Ahmed al Alawi. So as you know, he's Sheikh Ahmed al Alawi. He was born in Algeria, in the actual Algeria. He was from a noble family who was known for his piety and his knowledge in the science of Islam. So before he was born, his mother met a dream. She met a dream in which she saw the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, who gave her a flower of narcissus, and she was with very great fear of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, and she took that flower of narcissus, and she saw that in her dream he was eating that flower, and the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam smiled to her, and it was the announcement that she would have a baby who'd born from her and would be a great salih and a great wali of Allah. So Sheikh Ahmed al Alawi was born in 1869 in Mustaghanem, a city of Algeria, and he started first to have the traditional way in having the knowledge of Islam. He started to study the Quran and the fiqh. But he was not very. He didn't go very far away in his studies, because he, as he said in his biography, he memorized the Quran until the Surah Ar-Rahman. So you know from that when Allah decide to make a people to be his wali, it's not from his science or his knowledge he has got. Allah chooses the one he likes and met from him a wali. As Allah says, Allah yamunu wa ma yasha min al-ibad. He chose the one who he likes from his adorators, and he met him the wali. And that's the case of Sayyidina Ahmed al-Alawi, because he was not a people very known for his Islamic knowledge. He was not an alim, but he was one of the great saints and the great awliya of our ummah. So he started then to be in the trade. He was a trader. He had a little shop in Mustaghanem when he used to have trade. He was to make trade, but this time he had the eager to go to the tasawuf, and then he started to go to see the shuyukh of his region, the one who had piety and knowledge, and to go to be his companion. And he saw a sheikh of the Aisawiya, the tariqah Aisawiya, and he started to accompany him. And he said that in his biography, which has been written by Shahada ibn Tunis, which is called Al-Rawda al-Saniyya, he said that in that biography that he started to have some karamats. He was able to take snakes and to eat them without any danger, without any harm, and that it was the characteristic of that tariqah. When you enter in it, you had some harmful adat. You see, you can make something which are not habitual. Then Sheikh Ahmed al Alawi had that type of harmful adat. But he knows that it was not the way of Allah. He was interrogating himself, is that the way I can go to Allah? And he started to go to go out from that that group of Aisawiyah, because he knows that this is not the path to Allah. So in that point, we will talk about that point, because effectively, when you say the people of Allah, they do know what is the path to Allah. The path of to Allah is the ma'arif of Allah. The path you know your Lord to be able to worship Him, and not the path to when you have some karamat or when you make a lot of zikr. It's not the path of Allah. So it's what Sayyidina Ahmed al Alawi understood, and he wanted to grow out from that that group. And his in his shop, he had a friend who was working with him, and that friend knew a sheikh who was the sheikh Muhammad ibn Habib al Buzidi. So that sheikh Muhammad ibn Habib al Buzidi, from whom we met a biography, inshallah, was a wali of Allah, but he had gone from Morocco to go to Algeria, because at the time he had some problem with the other turuq of Sufia in Morocco. Then he wanted, he had the habit to come and to visit that friend of Sheikh Ahmed al Alawi. Then one day he went to that shop, and he was talking with Sheikh Ahmed al Alawi, and he was talking with the friend. He started to talk about Sheikh Ahmed al Alawi, and to say that people will be someone who will be in the path of Allah, who will be a great knower of Allah. No, Sheikh Ahmed al Alawi didn't take that point in serious, because he was knowing himself. And one other day, Sheikh Muhammad al-Buzidi asked, when he knew that Sheikh Ahmed al Alawi was in the tariqah Asawiyah, he told him, are you able to take snakes without any harm? Sheikh Ahmed al Alawi told him, yes, I can. So he said him, so go out of the city and bring the greatest snake you can. And then Sheikh Ahmed al Alawi went out to the city. He searched a snake. He took him, and then came back to Sheikh Muhammad al Buzidi. He asked him, "Is that the one you were able to take?" Yes, Sheikh Ahmed al Alawi said. Then Sheikh Muhammad al Buzidi told him, "Can I show you a greater and the greatest snake you can take, and that you is at the time harming you?" Sheikh Ahmed al Alawi said he said him yes. He told him, "Eat your nafs, which is in your sides, and then you will, if you make the effort, you will be able to take that snake and to master him." And then it was the beginning of the talks between Sheikh Ahmed al Alawi and Sheikh Muhammad al Buzidi. And sometime after, Sidi Ahmed al Alawi took the bay'ah with Sidi Muhammad al Buzidi, and he started then to make the zikr. And Sheikh Muhammad al Buzidi told him, "So now you will be working with Ism al Azam, the Ism Allah," and he told him how to make that zikr. At the time also, Sidi Ahmed al Alawi was using to go to a dars of ilm al tawhid, the ilm of kalam. And he told that to Sheikh Muhammad al Buzidi, and Sheikh Muhammad al Buzidi told him, "No, that is not the time, the science of tawhid. This is the time, science of tawhil." He told that the science with which you go in, you are sending yourself, and not the science with which you know do you know Allah in reality. So we'll have two points to talk about that. The first point is that the science of tawhid is not the reality of the science, because the science of tawhid is a science which you get with your haql. Then the science, the reality of tawhid is a science you get with your hat, and that is what Sidi Muhammad al Buzidi wanted to indicate to Sidi Ahmed al Alawi, and he told him that this is not the science of tawhid, but this is the science of tawhil. And the second point is that the tawhid, the reality of tawhid, you can just have it by accompanying a sheikh who is deeper in the science of tawheed, in the science of ma'rifah, and that the ma'rifah is the way for people to go to Allah, and the only door to go to that path of ma'rifah is to accompany a shaykh who is able to give you the nur of Allah and who is able to indicate you the path to your Lord. Then Sheikh Ahmed al Alawi then started in that time to, instead of going to the science of the dars of Tawheed, he started to make zikr in the third, the last third of the night, as our Sheikh Sin Wahid al-Fawzi al-Karkari tells us. Then he started then to have mushahadat and to see the nur of Allah. And then Sheikh Muhammad al-Buzidi told him, stop going to the science of Tawheed, and when your heart will be full of the nur of Allah, you will be able to understand what all that they say you in the science of Tawheed, in the ilm of kalam. The important point in that fact is the saying of Sidi Muhammad al-Buzidi, when your heart will be full of nur, so that nur will talk, we Karkari are talking about anytime you see it also mentioned in all the books of tasawuf and all the by all the chuyukh of that science. So you can know that when we talk about, we say that the nur is very important for you to know Allah, it's a thing which is real, a thing which is collaborated by the experience of the chuyukh which was before us. So this only mean to go to Allah is to have the nur in your heart. And also the point is that Sheikh Ahmed al Alawi said after that, when he started to make effort of and zikr in the last third of the night, he was seeing mushahadat. So he was seeing in a state of awakening the malakut, as you can say, because the things are the things of malakut, what you see in your mushahadat. So he started to see the things of malakut, and then he understood the reality of tawhid. And when he came back to his dars of Hilmul Kalam, he was able to correct the shaykh and to tell him that what you are seeing here is false, and before he said something, to know that as the point in which he was aiming to go. It shows you also that the ilm of tawhid, the reality of tawhid, can just be gained by the zikr which mushahadat. The zikr which mushahadat, the first mushahada is the mushahada of the nur of Allah, and then some other things of the malakut which permit you to understand the reality of tawhid. And so as our Sheikh Sin Muhammad Fawzi al-Karkari says, tariqatuna tariqatul mushahada man la yushahid falastu bi shaykhihi wa laysa bi muridi. As our Sheikh says, our tariqah, the tariqah al-Karkariya, is the tariqah of the vision in the state of awakening. The one who doesn't see of my murids, I am not his sheikh and he is not my murid. As what we can understand from that is that in our tariqah, when you can and you take the bay'ah of Sina Sheikh Ahmed Muhammad Fawzi al-Karkari, you will have mushahadat. You will see at least the nur of Allah. And if you see the nur of Allah, alhamdulillah, you have see all that. You can help, because Allah says in the Quran, Allah nur samawati wal ard. He didn't give any indication of his that except nur in the Quran. So when you see the nur of Allah, you see an indication of the that of Allah, and this is a thing most important you can get. And then Sheikh Ahmed al Alawi, you can back to the biography of Sheikh Ahmed al Alawi. And then we went just to make some points important in his biography, and not exhaustive biography, because you can Sheikh Ahmed al Alawi is very known in the world. If you want, you can go to the book of Martin Links, who talk in detail with the biography of Sheikh Ahmed al Alawi. But we went just to point out some things of his biography and to make it in mirror with our era. Then Sheikh Ahmed al Alawi started to get bigger and bigger in his ma'rifah, And when Shia Muhammad al-Buzidi radiallahu anhu, who passed away, he was the one who was his inheritor in the tarbiyah of the murid. And all people make bay'ah with him. And he started to make people enter to khulwa and to give them the sir of Allah and guide him to his ma'rifah. What we can say also is that when he started to make that his teachings, all the Sufi of his era, as in his own city, and also in his own tariqah, the tariqah Darqawiya at the time, started to be against him. They started to say that Shaykh Ahmed al Alawi was a sahir, he was a witch, and that he was a witcher, and that he was out of the Sharia. So it's also some of the fitan that you see anytime that people that the people of Allah appear. And as we can see also in our tariqah, people are saying insanities about us when what we just call out is the nur of Allah and the mahabba of Allah and his ma'rifah. And so it was some point we wanted to talk about in that biography. So Sayyid Ahmed al Alawi is very known. So he passed away in 1936. And when he died, alhamdulillah, he had spread all nur and all ma'rifah with very great people of Allah, as Sidi Muhammad al-Madani or Sidi Muhammad al-Hashimi, and as we saw, Sidi Malay Tahir al-Karkari. So some point we wanted to talk about is biography of Sheikh Ahmed al-Alawi. Allahum barik lana fi shuyukhina kulluhum jami'an ya rabbal alamin wa anfa'na min barakatihim wa la tawaffana illa wa hum radin 'anna ya rahman ya rahim subhana rabbika rabbil 'izzati 'amma yasifun wa salamun 'alal mursalin walhamdulillahi rabbil 'alamin.